Namaste, welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm making very traditional recipe lapsi. And it is specialty of Gujarat where I grew up. Any auspicious occasion, this sweet must be there. Earlier I shared the video, the very traditional way of preparing this lapsi, but today I'm going to show you the quick way of making this lapsi. So today basically I'm going to prepare in a pressure cooker. If you don't have a pressure cooker, you can watch my other video where I prepare lapsi in an open pot. Lapsi is basically a cracked wheat. It is also known as para lapsi. So here how it looks like, you can see that, and you can find this easily at any Indian grocers. So let's start making lapsi. Here I have all the ingredients ready. Half cup of lapsi, 1/3 cup of ghee, clarified butter, half cup of sugar. Usually traditionally all these measurements are taken in the same amount. If you take half cup of lapsi, you take half cup of ghee and half cup of sugar. So you don't have to even remember the measurement. Now water, usually you have to add double, triple. It depends the lapsi, how old lapsi. Sometimes it takes a little more, sometimes it takes a little less. Today I'm going to add about 1.5 cups of water, and if I need more I'll add later, but because I'm going to use pressure cooker I have to have sufficient amount of water so that it doesn't stick at the bottom. And here I have some dry fruits, kesar, saffron and cardamom, elaichi. Now there are some other whole spices added, cinnamon stick, cloves and everything, so I'm going to add that too. So first of all, I'm going to heat up this pressure cooker here. Turn on the stove on a medium heat in the beginning. And first, I'm going to roast this lapsi. Make sure that you roast till it changes a slight different color, like a little bit golden brown color. All right, so here I have this pot and I'm going to add this ghee, clarified butter. And here I have this cloves and cinnamon. Touch and loving. Now here I have this lapsi, half cup of lapsi, para lapsi known as, and I'm going to roast on a low to medium heat till it slightly changes the color, kind of a pink color you will see. And make sure to roast on a low heat. Now you can see that it has changed color to a little bit golden brown color. So at this point I'm going to add 1.5 cups of water. Now in some other part of India, some people make this lapsi with milk. Instead of water, they add milk and cook the lapsi, but I'm going to stick to my traditional recipe. And at this point, I'm also going to add this cashew and raisins, kaju and drax. And here I have the kesar, saffron. And now I'm going to cover this pressure cooker. All right, and I'm going to hear about 10 whistles. You will have to hear more whistles because we want to cook this lapsi properly. You will get the aroma of kind of cooked lapsi, so you will come to know. But all right, so I heard 10 whistles and now I'm ready to open and I'll show you how it looks like now. All right, so make sure that the air is out. Now look at this, it's still very hot because I removed all the air. But you can allow it to cool down naturally and then you can open. But this is how it looks like now. Perfect. It's nicely cooked. Looks great. And now I'm ready to add this sugar. I took out sugar from half cup even. So now I'm adding only about 1/3 cup of sugar. You can always adjust the amount of sugar, how sweet you want, less or more. And now I'm going to again turn on the stove on a low to medium heat and I'm going to cook again for a little bit till sugar gets turned into kind of a sugar syrup. So we want to make sure that our lapsi should look thicker. So I'm going to cook again for a little bit. So basically once the sugar melts, you want to cook again for a little bit because now you can see that it has turned into kind of a, it looks like a liquidy. So we want to cook again to get a little thicker. We don't have to cook much now, but we just want to make sure that the sugar gets a little thicker. So basically we want to cook till ghee, the clarified butter, separates out, so you will automatically come to know when you see the ghee coming out of this laps. Traditionally, lapsi is cooked for hours and hours to get the nice taste, and the slow cooked aroma is so wonderful during wedding especially. Now I can see that the clarified butter oozes out on the edges. Actually, you can see that if you add more ghee, then you can see it clearly, but I can see right now on the edges that the ghee has separated out from the lapsi. So I'm going to turn off the stove at this time. All right, so the lapsi is ready, and it looks yummy. I'm going to give it a bite here. It's very hot. And the color also looks great. Now on the top, you can also sprinkle some more nuts. Here I have the almond, the slivered almond, and a cardamom, lychee. Here I have this serving plate. I'm going to take out into this plate here. Here I can see the cashews and raisins. And look at this. Now on the top, here I have some slivered almond and cardamom. Lychee. So this was all about making lapsi on any auspicious occasion, or even you can just make any day of the year. I really love this lapsi with our complete menu. We make dal bhat and lapsi. It's a rice and dal and this lapsi. So thank you for watching, and I will see you soon with the next great recipe.